is morning and evening shade, and this is the old hardware store of Mr. Arb Newton, a man who refused to use gimmicks or to sell plastic stuff that tears up the next day. Instead, he sold wheelbarrows and hammers and garden gloves, things that people really need. In a world of whiny, neurotic, self-indulgent people, Mr. Arb shone like a booster rocket. Lots of folks around here still miss him, but this week, the 30th anniversary of his death, he will be mostly and quietly remembered by one person, and that person is his son.
Dad, would you listen to this? Dad?
Hmm? Oh, I'm sorry, honey, what is it?
He's supposed to make up a fable that has a moral to it.
A fable? Isn't he a little young for a fable?
He's gifted.
Yeah, I keep forgetting.
There's a boy named Will. His mother bought him some pants-up pennies. He went to recess, he tore the pants up, and he got in trouble.
What's the lesson?
Don't buy pants-up pennies.
Sounds good to me. Want to go help your brother bring that stuff over here?
Dad?
Uh-huh?
Would you buy me a bra?
Oh, honey, you're just a little girl. I don't want you to wear a bra yet. You know that little undershirt you wear? I'd like you to wear that the rest of your life.
Daddy.
Sorry, Dad, they're out of sweetener. You want me to go next door to Stop and Go?
No, I'll just have it back.
All right, well, this is mine.
I had the Kiss Sunrise sandwich. I knew it. It's a dinosaur. I've already got a dinosaur.
I got a ring in the clothes.
That's what I wanted. How come I couldn't have that box?
Because that's the way life is. Sometimes you get the wrong box, you know? You gotta be a good sport about it.
When's Mom supposed to bait on the radio?
7:30.
Hey, Dad, you know what I was thinking about?
No, what?
Well, what if Mom gets elected prosecuting attorney and, say, after I get my driver's license, I get arrested for something? Would Mom prosecute her own son?
Yes, she would. Your mother has a very high sense of morality, and she would never show favoritism. As a matter of fact, once she's elected, if any of you do anything wrong, you'll all go to prison.
Mr. Evans?
Yes?
I'm Fontana Beausoleil, the striptease artist.
Oh, sure. I'm familiar with her work. Not personally, but I've heard about it.
Well, I want to thank you for that wonderful editorial you wrote criticizing government interference in the arts.
Thank you. I try.
You succeed.
Your change, Mr. Evans.
Oh, thank you. Well, what are you all doing here? Your toaster blow up?
Reading out because Mom had to go debate Jim Guy Puckett on the radio.
Is that this morning? I thought it was tomorrow.
You enjoy the kitty breakfast?
Yes, I do. Just the right portion.
Grandpa, what prize did you get in yours?
I got a ring that glows.
Can I have it?
Nope. I'm keeping it for myself.
Who is doing all that honking?
That is my sister, also known as your mother's Aunt Frieda. We're on our way to a board meeting at the newspaper. She insisted on going through the drive-through window. I come in here because I don't like to eat in the car. She's staying out there because she doesn't like to eat in here.
Hey, here it is.
We're talking this morning with Evening Shade prosecuting attorney Jim Guy Puckett and his opponent in the upcoming general election, Mrs. Ava Newton.
If I can, Randy, I'd like to get back to the downtown parking meter situation.
Well, I think a far more pressing problem is our lack of a domestic violence unit.
Good shot.
May I take your order, please?
Wood Newton.
Excuse me?
Is my nephew Wood Newton in there?
Yes, he is.
I thought that was his car out here. What's he doing?
He's drinking coffee.
Well, anyway, I'd like one of those Egg McMuffin deals, and I'd like the egg to be real well done.
You know, some mornings that voice goes right through me. Now that I've heard it on a microphone.
Yep, somewhere there's a moose slapping on Aramis.
Listen, maybe the egg should be medium and the muffin toasted bread.
I'm sorry, ma'am. We don't McMuffin here. That's McDonald's.
Well, where the hell am I?
You wonder why I don't drive through with her?
You're at Artie's.
Artie's? What have you got?
Ma'am, the menu's right in front of you.
I don't have my reading glasses, and I just cannot believe you don't have that McMuffin thing. I mean, what do I have to do? Go out on the interstate?
Yes, ma'am. That's where McDonald's is.
Well, that's ridiculous. Do you have cafe au lait?
No, we don't.
Well, then just give me a damn paper cup and tell my brother to get out of this car right now. We are never coming here again.
Okay.
It's kind of embarrassing, is.
And I would certainly support immediate warrants in those cases and not a 24-hour cooling-off period. Excuse me, but I'm not feeling very well, Randy. Do you think we could go to commercial?
Sure thing, Ava. Or are you all right? Just hang on.
So that's what your lab tests say. These things sometimes happen during pregnancy. And just to make sure that you have no early preeclampsia, I'd like to keep you here 3 or 4 days.
3 or 4 days? Harlan, I've got a campaign to run. Besides, I can be quiet at home.
Now, we got to monitor this medicine. It's got some side effects, mainly nausea and fever.
I know you're upset, honey, but we better go along with them.
Well, I can't just stay in bed. I've got all these leaflets to give out. I'm supposed to be at the mall tonight, and Smiley's compost plant at 6 a.m.
We'll hand out the leaflets for you.
That's right. I'll take some to the mall. I was going out there anyway to return some midget pantyhose.
I guess that leaves me with the compost.
I'm just going to tell you one thing, Wood Newton. Don't you do like you did that time Ava came up here and her toe was getting operated on and you tried to sneak right into bed with her.
I don't know where you come up with these incredibly bizarre stories.
See, I know that Merlin will be glad to have your kids, so why don't you bring them on out to Tara?
Oh, please. If they want to visit Disney World, let them go to Orlando.
Flamingos and ostriches, those kids will go wild.
And anyway, you and Merlin have gone nuts out there on that plantation of yours. It's like Scarlet O'Hara's Wild Kingdom.
Rita, I want you to be quiet. It's bad enough I have to listen to you yakking on the intercom at Artie's. Anyway, I've got a solution to this whole thing. I think your mother ought to keep Molly. Taylor can stay with me, and you can keep Will.
No,
no, don't you want to get those kids up?
Wait a minute! I have something to say about this.
You didn't eat anything this morning, did you?
No.
Is that hypoglycemia kicking in?
Need to go out to that snack machine, get you some cheese.
All right, I'll have some cheese, but we want our kids to stay in our house with me.
Well, I guess that leaves me no other choice.
What does that mean?
Oh, I have to move in with you.
Man, I can't believe all the food people keep bringing here. We're going to have to buy another refrigerator.
Ew, what is that stuff?
That is the Donna Bader's banana pudding. Her husband used to be granddaddy's yard man. Oh, I drove by their house the other day. Well, he had this big old sign out in the front yard, live bait. B-A-T-E. It makes me crazy. You know, it's stuff like that that makes everybody think we're stupid. You know, when Ava becomes prosecuting attorney, there ought to be a law. If you can't spell bait, you can't sell it.
Okay.
Hey, Aunt Frieda, do you know that word?
It's heureuse, as in, je suis très heureuse. I am very happy.
Heureuse.
Well, that's good. Oh, I certainly hope you're going to have a better French accent than Billy Faye Wiley. Oh, I will never forget. In foreign language one, how Miss Teeter used to try and get him to say his name in French. Je m'appelle Jimmy Faye Wiley. But he would always pronounce it Jim's apple, Billy Faye Wiley. That is the kind of thing that drives me crazy. It's just like when the local radio announcers try to pronounce the names of the perfume down on sale at Fauches. I mean, it's never Jean Natalie. It's always Get Your Jean Natty. Lord, I hope and pray they don't ever have a sale on Anise Anise.
More coffee, Frieda?
Now, I'm having my cafe mocha with mint.
You know, I was just thinking, you've been here for 3 days, and Ava gets back tomorrow. Everything seems to be in order. And by the way, you've done a wonderful job.
Thank you.
But maybe you'd like to go home now and unwind, so to speak.
Can't. I have to take the laundry over to Althea Roberts and get her to do it today. You know, she does all the washing and ironing except when her arthritis gets her down.
No, you don't have to, because Merlene picked up the laundry.
You kidding? I didn't see her do that.
Well, she threw it in her big pink Cadillac, you know, the Eldorado, and she took off with it. If you see her, maybe you could have her come back, because I don't have any underwear.
Oh, I'm going to tell you, Thursday is her date to go to the dog races in Memphis. I wouldn't be surprised if your underwear's there right now. You know what? I read in a magazine the other day, Faye Dunaway goes to a psychiatrist every day of her natural life. Now, I think that's neurotic.
That's neurotic.
It's neurotic, darling. Enunciation is everything. I once knew a man named Jackstrap.
Rita?
Yeah.
I'm sorry, but you're going to have to shut up. Because if you don't, I'm going to rip this cord off the toaster and strangle you.
Daddy?
Well, maybe not. Maybe I'll have some more cheese.
Dad's just kidding, Aunt Frieda.
Oh, darling, I don't pay any attention to him. Your daddy wouldn't have the nerve to kill me because I'd come back and haunt him. You know what I would come back as? A big old dumb football player who's always running the wrong way. That's what I'm going to be in my next life, and then I'm going to try out for your team, and you're not going to know which one is really me.
Hello?
Hi.
Oh, hi. How are you feeling?
I'm okay.
Wood, is this peignoir you bought me for Valentine's Day the best you could find in my pajama drawer?
Well, I like it. I like you in red. What's wrong with it?
Nothing. I'm just afraid the nurses are going to think I have another business on the side.
I miss you.
I miss you, too. I know you can't say anything, but...
I'm sure by now Frida's driving you crazy, right? If she is, just say something like, I haven't seen Brownie today. He must be under the porch.
I haven't seen Brownie today. He must have thrown himself on a high-voltage fence.
Bad, huh?
You ought to get some rest.
Okay.
I love you, kid.
I love you, too.
Bye.
Bye.
Good morning.
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 Just came by to make sure you're all still standing. I didn't see any smoke signals during the night.
Oh, I was up. I watched that movie, The Two Miss Grenvilles with Anne Margaret. Boy, she has stood up well. Oh, look at the time. If your daddy's not going in till 10, I'm going to have to take you to school. Come on, I'm just going to get my purse. Come on, come on, guys.
I want her out of here. She's driving me insane. No wonder she went to the state hospital. She couldn't get away from herself.
Well, it's just one more day.
I can't take one more day. I can't listen to that voice for one more minute. I'd rather take a spike and drive it right through my crotch.
Don't tell me about her. I grew up with her. We were the first people in town to get an air conditioner just because it drowned out some of the noise.
It starts in the morning and it goes till we go to bed. She never stops. Look, I don't care why Secretary of State James Baker wears the same green tie every day. And I don't want to know who was the guest host on the Tonight Show last night. And I sure don't care about Lodi Hickman's brother, who went off and joined the revolution in South America and spent the whole time in a bar drinking beer all day long, so much so that when he came home, he looked like a big old pie wagon. I don't care.
You need to get a hold of yourself.
I know. I don't know who to turn to, I tell you. You know that in the South, when you say to somebody, you know, y'all spend the night tonight, we don't mean it. Nobody ever stays. But you can get right up in her face and say, I don't want you here anymore. She doesn't move.
I can see you're right on the edge here. Look, I have been her brother for over half a century, and I'm going to tell you something about her. You can't best her, you can't out-talk her, you can't outdo her. She's kind of like Frankenstein. She just keeps moving at you. Now, you just might as well give up.
Well, thank you for those inspirational words. Maybe you'd like to give a pep talk to my football team at halftime.
Grandpa, would you read my fable?
It's a fable that he has to have for school.
Read your fable. My grandpa's old yard man sold bait, but he spelled it wrong on the sign. No people bought any. Here's the lesson. If you can't spell bait, don't sell it. That's pretty good. I like that.
At least gifted. It takes after our side.
I just came by to tell you I won't be able to play poker here tonight.
You're kidding. Why not?
Well, it's a darndest thing. Your old friend Fontana Beau Soleil called me up and asked me to dinner.
What for?
Well, I don't know, Frida. I guess she likes me.
Let me get this straight. You would rather go out on a date than play poker with Ponder and Harlan and I?
That's correct. I don't want to hurt your feelings, but you guys are really not quite as fascinating to me as you may have previously imagined.
Well, I think you should have as much fun in life as you can while you're here, because 30 years after you're gone, nobody will remember.
Let me tell you, you don't have to worry about your game. Once again, the fates have smiled on you.
Why is that?
I play poker! Everybody's so all fire hepped up about the Japanese. I didn't think that Infiniti car ad of theirs is so hot. All you heard for weeks was, ooh, it's coming soon. It's like a leaf in the breeze, like a pebble in the pond. Hell, I thought some new feminine hygiene product was coming to America.
Too bad Evan can't play tonight.
Okay, this is $30. Now bring us a couple of six packs and some corn chips, pork rinds, beef jerky, and a jar of macadamia nuts.
Boy, that's a lot to carry.
Well, no, you got that big old wagon there, and if you don't want to do it, then don't do it.
No, it's all right, I'll do it. As long as I can feel secure within myself that you're not exploiting me. Hey, ho, you got that bone ready to go.
What's that all about?
He's been watching Phil Donahue through the window down at Dickie's appliance store.
You know, Ponder, I wish you hadn't brought Evan up. I, for one, cannot believe my own brother is right next door entertaining that low-rent, loose-legged, roadhouse dancer, Fontana Beau Soleil. But, you know, except for Ava's mama, he always has had the strangest taste in women. Oh, just like that Ora Faye Felder in high school. And it's always the ones whose parents are real religious. They don't let them wear any makeup. And at every dance, there she'd be in the back seat of another car, bouncing up and down like an oil well. But not a trace of makeup on her. I'm gonna go check on the kids.
She is whipping our butts.
Yeah, but the thing that gets me is she don't even know what she's doing. And we gotta stop this dealer's choice. I never heard of no peaky around the world. And spit on the king.
She's making it up.
Yeah, but she's winning. I say we just go back to five card stud.
You have your doctor's bag with you?
No, why?
Sodium pentothal. We could sedate her.
Why? She'd only keep talking on in her sleep.
This is your laundry. All pressed and folded.
Well, you didn't have to do that, Merlene. I do my own laundry once in a while.
Oh, now, I wanted to help out. Anyway, I just love to press things. You are going to think I'm crazy, but I even pressed the little flap on your boxer shorts. I hope that wasn't too personal.
Merlene, for crying out loud, we're trying to have a game of cards here. You didn't give a damn whether you press the flap in his boxer shorts.
Well, I am sorry, Harlan. I was just trying to be nice.
I know, honey cakes, but we're trying to play poker, and sometimes you just say things that are not pertinent.
Well, can you beat that? And this is from a man whose main topic of dinner conversation for the last 40 years has been asking people if their meat's tender.
Where are my kids?
Well, Taylor's upstairs, and the two little ones over next door spying on their granddaddy.
I don't want them to do that.
You just keep out of it. They're working for me now.
I think you ought to know that none of us is going to get excited about putting one card on our foreheads again.
Let me just ask you something. Is it true what they say about all black men?
Yeah.
Frida, there's something about you that's not right.
Frida, you're never going to believe it. We peeked in the window, and then Grandpa and that lady were dancing real close, and she had on that ring that glows.
Oh, my Lord, he's lost his mind. Well, whatever it is, we're going to have it annulled.
Ask him, Merlene.
You know, Wood,
mm?
I think that you should let Molly have a bra. Even Barbie has a bra, and she's not even alive.
Hey, Dwayne.
Oh, hey, Coach. I got you some flowers. I'm sorry it's so late, but we're running behind tonight.
Where are they from?
They're from Ava.
Ava?
Oh, my gosh, Coach. I'm sorry. These are supposed to go to the cemetery. They're for your dad, Mr. Opp.
That's all right. I'll take them. Thank you.
Okay, I appreciate it. I'm sorry, Coach.
That's all right.
You have a nice evening, okay?
You too.
So worried about you. Did you go to the cemetery?
You know, as the years go by, I realize more and more, no matter what my problem is, that you're the answer.
Don't forget to come and get me tomorrow.
Fat chance.
I love you.
Where's that music coming from?
My brother's house. That's the lovely Fontana's theme song. She's probably over there dancing for him. Where's Wood?
You talk so much, he probably went to bed.
What do you mean I talk to him? I do not talk to him.
You're talking right now. Look at that.
And so we're given another fable. There once was a boy named Wood who lost his father at 17. He grew up and married a beautiful girl with bright red hair. His daddy never saw all the touchdowns he made, but she did. And somehow, it was almost as good.
Smoke signals during the night.
Oh, I was up. I watched that movie. The two Miss Grenvilles with Anne Margaret. Boy, she has stood up well. Oh, look at the time. If your daddy's not going in till 10, I'm going to have to take you to school. Come on, I'm just going to get my purse. Come on. Come on, guys.
I want her out of here. She's driving me insane. No wonder she went to the state hospital. She couldn't get away from herself.
It's just one more day.
I can't take one more day. I can't listen to that voice for one more minute. I'd rather take a spike and drive it right through my crotch.
Don't tell me about her. I grew up with her. We were the first people in town to get an air conditioner just because it drowned out some of the noise.
It starts in the morning and it goes till we go to bed.
She never stops. Look, I don't care why Secretary of State James Baker wears the same green tie every day. I don't want to know who was the guest host on The Tonight Show last night. And I sure don't care about Lodi Hickman's brother, who went off and joined the revolution in South America and spent the whole time in a bar drinking beer all day long, so much so that when he came home, he looked like a big old pie wagon. I don't care.
You need to get a hold of yourself.
I know. I don't know who to turn to. I tell you, you know that in the South, when you say to somebody, you know, y'all spend the night tonight, we don't mean it. Nobody ever stays. But you can get right up in her face and say, I don't want you here anymore. She doesn't move.
I can see you're right on the edge here. Look, I have been her brother for over half a century, and I'm going to tell you something about her. You can't best her. You can't out-talk her. You can't outdo her. She's kind of like Frankenstein. She just keeps moving at you. Now, you just might as well give up.
Well, thank you for those inspirational words. Maybe you'd like to give a pep talk to my football team at halftime.
Grandpa, would you read my fable?
It's a fable that he has to have for school.
Read your fable. My grandpa's old yard man sold bait, but he spelled it wrong on the sign. No people bought any. Here's the lesson. If you can't spell bait, don't sell it. That's pretty good. I like that.
At least gifted. He takes after our side.
Listen, I just came by to tell you I won't be able to play poker here tonight.
You're kidding. Why not?
Well, it's the darndest thing. Your old friend Fontana Beau Soleil called me up and asked me to dinner.
What for?
Well, I don't know, Frida. I guess she likes me.
Let me get this straight. You would rather go out on a date than play poker with Ponder and Harlan and I?
That's correct. I don't want to hurt your feelings, but you guys are really not quite as fascinating to me as you may have previously imagined.
Well, I think you should have as much fun in life as you can while you're here, because 30 years after you're gone, nobody will remember.
Let me tell you, you don't have to worry about your game. Once again, the fates have smiled on you.
Why is that?
I play poker! Everybody's so all fire-hepped up about the Japanese. I didn't think that Infinity car ad of theirs is so hot. All you heard for weeks was, ooh, it's coming soon. It's like a leaf in the breeze, like a pebble in the pond. Hell, I thought some new feminine hygiene product was coming to America.
Too bad Evan can't play tonight.
Okay, this is $30. Now, bring us a couple of six-packs and some corn chips, pork rinds, beef jerky, and a jar of macadamia nuts.
Boy, that's a lot to carry.
Well, Dub, you got that big old wagon there, and if you don't want to do it, then don't do it.
No, it's all right. I'll do it. As long as I can feel secure within myself that you're not exploiting me.
Hey, ho, ho, you got that bone ready to go. What's that all about?
He's been watching Phil Donahue through the window down at Dickie's appliance store.
You know, Ponder, I wish you hadn't brought Evan up. I, for one, cannot believe my own brother is right next door entertaining that low-rent, loose-legged roadhouse dancer, Fontana Beau Soleil. But, you know, except for Ava's mama, he always has had the strangest taste in women. Oh, just like that Aura Faye Felker in high school. And it's always the ones whose parents are real religious. They don't let them wear any makeup. And at every dance, there she'd be in the back seat of another car, bouncing up and down like an oil well. But not a trace of makeup on her. I'm gonna go check on the kids.
She is whipping our butts.
Yeah, but the thing that gets me is she don't even know what she's doing. And we gotta stop this dealer's choice. I never heard of no peaky around the world. Spit on the king.
She's making it up.
Yeah, but she's winning. I said we just go back to five-card stud.
You have your doctor's bag with you?
No, why?
Sodium pentothal. We could sedate her.
Why? She'd only keep talking on in her sleep.
This is your laundry, all pressed and folded.
We didn't have to do that, Merlene. I do my own laundry once in a while.
Oh, now, I wanted to help out. Anyway, I just love to press things. You are going to think I'm crazy, but I even pressed the little flap on your boxer shorts. I hope that wasn't too personal.
I mean, for crying out loud, we're trying to have a game of cards here. You don't give a damn whether you press the flap on his boxer shorts.
Well, I am sorry, Holland. I was just trying to be nice.
I know, honey cakes, but we're trying to play poker, and sometimes you just say things that are not pertinent. Well, can you beat that? And this is from a man whose main topic of dinner conversation for the last 40 years has been asking people if their meat's tender.
Where are my kids?
Well, Taylor's upstairs, and two little ones over next door spying on their granddaddy.
I don't want them to do that.
You just keep out of it. They're working for me now.
I think you ought to know that none of us is going to get excited about putting one card on our foreheads again.
Let me just ask you something. Is it true what they say about all black men?
Yeah.
Frida, there's something about you that's not right.
We're dancing real close, and she had on that ring that glows.
Oh, my Lord, he's lost his mind. Well, whatever it is, we're gonna have it annulled.
Ask you, Merlene.
You know, Wood?
Hmm?
I think that you should let Molly have a bra. Even Barbie has a bra, and she's not even alive.
Wayne. Oh, hey, Coach. I got you some flowers. I'm sorry.
Bate. B-A-T-E. It makes me crazy. You know, it's stuff like that that makes everybody think we're stupid. You know, when Ava becomes prosecuting attorney, there ought to be a law. If you can't spell bait, you can't sell it.
Okay.
Hey, Aunt Frieda.
Mm.
Do you know that word?
Mm. It's heureuse, as in je suis très heureuse. I am very happy.
Elise.
Well, that's good. Oh, I certainly hope you're going to have a better French accent than Billy Faye Wiley. Oh, I will never forget. In Foreign Language 1, how Miss Teeter used to try and get him to say his name in French. Je m'appelle Jimmy Faye Wiley. But he would always pronounce it Jim's apple, Billy Faye Wiley. That is the kind of thing that drives me crazy. It's just like when the local radio announcers try to pronounce the names of the perfume down on sale at Fauches. I mean, it's never Jean Natalie. It's always Get Your Jean Natty. Lord, I hope and pray they don't ever have a sale on Anise Anise.
More coffee, Frida?
Now, I'm having my cafe mocha with mint.
You know, I was just thinking, you've been here for 3 days, and Ava gets back tomorrow. Everything seems to be in order. And by the way, you've done a wonderful job.
Thank you.
But maybe you'd like to go home now and unwind, so to speak.
Can't. I have to take the laundry over to Althea Roberts and get her to do it today. You know, she says I'm washing and ironing except when her arthritis gets her down.
No, you don't have to, because Merlene picked up the laundry.
You cannot see her do that.
Well, she threw it in her big pink Cadillac, you know, the Eldorado, and she took off with it. If you see her, maybe you could have her come back, because I don't have any underwear.
Oh, I'm going to tell you, Thursday is her date to go to the dog races in Memphis. I wouldn't be surprised if your underwear's there right now. You know what? I read in a magazine the other day, Faye Dunaway goes to a psychiatrist every day of her natural life. Now, I think that's neurotic.
That's neurotic.
It's neurotic, darling. Enunciation is everything. I once knew a man named Jackstrap.
Frida?
Yeah?
I'm sorry, but you're going to have to shut up. Because if you don't, I'm going to rip this cord off the toaster and strangle you.
Daddy?
Well, maybe not. Maybe I'll have some more cheese.
Dad's just kidding, Aunt Frieda.
Oh, John, I don't pay any attention to him. Your daddy wouldn't have the nerve to kill me because I'd come back and haunt him. You know what I would come back as? A big old dumb football player who's always running the wrong way. That's what I'm going to be in my next life. And then I'm going to try out for your team, and you're not going to know which one is really me.
Hello?
Hi.
Oh, hi. How are you feeling?
I'm okay.
Wood, is this penware you bought me for Valentine's Day the best you could find in my pajama drawer?
Well, I like it. I like you in red. What's wrong with it?
Nothing. I'm just afraid the nurses are going to think I have another business on the side.
I miss you.
I miss you, too. I know you can't say anything, but...
I'm sure by now Frieda's driving you crazy, right? If she is, just say something like, I haven't seen Brownie today. He must be under the porch.
I haven't seen Brownie today. He must have thrown himself on a high-voltage fence.
Bad, huh?
You ought to get some rest.
Okay.
I love you, kid.
I love you, too.
Bye.
Bye.
Good morning.
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 Just came by to make sure you're all still standing.
Jim Guy Puckett and his opponent in the upcoming general election, Mrs. Ava Newton.
If I can, Randy, I'd like to get back to the downtown parking meter situation.
Well, I think a far more pressing problem is our lack of a domestic violence unit.
Good shot.
May I take your order, please?
Wood Newton.
Excuse me?
Is my nephew Wood Newton in there?
Yes, he is.
I thought that was his car out here. What's he doing?
He's drinking coffee.
Well, anyway, I'd like one of those Egg McMuffin deals, and I'd like the egg to be real well done.
You know, some mornings that voice goes right through me. Now that I've heard it on a microphone.
Yep, somewhere there's a moose slapping on Aramis.
Listen, maybe the egg should be medium and the muffin toasted bread.
I'm sorry, ma'am, we don't have Egg McMuffin here. That's McDonald's.
Well, where the hell am I?
You wonder why I don't drive through with her?
You're at Artie's.
Artie's? What have you got?
Ma'am, the menu's right in front of you.
I don't have my reading glasses, and I just cannot believe you don't have that McMuffin thing. I mean, what do I have to do? Go out on the interstate?
Yes, ma'am. That's where McDonald's is.
Well, that's ridiculous. Do you have cafe au lait?
No, we don't.
Well, then just give me a damn paper cup and tell my brother to get out of this car right now. We are never coming here again.
Okay.
It's kind of embarrassing, isn't it?
And I would certainly support immediate warrants in those cases and not a 24-hour cooling-off period. Excuse me, but I'm not feeling very well, Randy. Do you think we could go to commercial?
Sure thing, Ava. Or are you all right? Just hang on.
So that's what your lab tests say. These things sometimes happen during pregnancy.
And just to make sure that you have no early preeclampsia, I'd like to keep you here 3 or 4 days.
3 or 4 days? Harlan, I've got a campaign to run. Besides, I can be quiet at home.
Now, we gotta monitor this medicine. It's got some side effects, mainly nausea and fever.
I know you're upset, honey, but we better go along with them.
Well, I can't just stay in bed. I've got all these leaflets to give out. I'm supposed to be at the mall tonight, and it's Smiley's compost plant at 6 a.m.
We'll hand out the leaflets for you.
That's right. I'll take some to the mall. I was going out there anyway to return some midget pantyhose.
I guess that leaves me with the compost.
I'm just going to tell you one thing, Wood Newton. Don't you do like you did that time Ava came up here and her toe was getting operated on and you tried to sneak right into bed with her.
I don't know where you come up with these incredibly bizarre stories.
Say, I know that Merlin will be glad to have your kids, so why don't you bring them on out to Tara?
Oh, please. If they want to visit Disney World, let them go to Orlando.
Flamingos and ostriches. Those kids will go wild.
And anyway, you and Merlin have gone nuts out there on that plantation of yours. It's like Scarlet O'Hara's Wild Kingdom.
Frieda, I want you to be quiet. It's bad enough I have to listen to you yakking on the intercom at Artie's. Anyway, I've got a solution to this whole thing. I think your mother ought to keep Molly. Taylor can stay with me and you can keep Will.
No,
don't you want to get those kids up?
Wait a minute!
I have something to say about this.
You didn't eat anything this morning, did you?
No.
Is that hypoglycemia kicking in?
Need to go out to that snack machine, get you some cheese.
All right, I'll have some cheese, but we want our kids to stay in our house with me.
Well, I guess that leaves me no other choice.
What does that mean?
Oh, I have to move in with you.
Man, I can't believe all the food people keep bringing here. We're going to buy another refrigerator.
Ew, what is that stuff?
That is the Donna Bader's banana pudding. Her husband used to be granddaddy's yard man. Oh, I drove by their house the other day. Well, he had this big old sign out in the front yard, live.
It's morning and evening shade, and this is the old hardware store of Mr. Arb Newton, a man who refused to use gimmicks or to sell plastic stuff that tears up the next day. Instead, he sold wheelbarrows and hammers and garden gloves, things that people really need. In a world of whiny, neurotic, self-indulgent people, Mr. Arb shone like a booster rocket. Lots of folks around here still miss him, but this week, the 30th anniversary of his death, he will be mostly and quietly remembered by one person, and that person is his son.
Dad, would you listen to this? Dad.
Hmm? Oh, I'm sorry, honey, what is it?
He's supposed to make up a fable that has a moral to it.
A fable? Isn't he a little young for a fable?
He's gifted.
Yeah, I keep forgetting.
There's a boy named Will. His mother bombed some pants up pennies. He went to recess, he tore the pants up, and he got in trouble.
What's the lesson?
Don't buy pants up pennies.
Sounds good to me. Want to go help your brother bring that stuff over here?
Yes, sir. Dad?
Uh-huh?
Would you buy me a bra?
Uh-huh, you're just a little girl. I don't want you to wear a bra yet. You know that little undershirt you wear? I'd like you to wear that. The rest of your life.
Daddy.
Sorry, Dad, they're out of sweetener. You want me to go next door to Stop and Go?
No, I'll just have it back.
All right, well, this is mine.
I had the Kiss Sunrise sandwich.
I knew it. It's a dinosaur.
I've already got a dinosaur.
I got a ring in the clothes.
That's what I wanted. How come I couldn't have that box?
Because that's the way life is. Sometimes you get the wrong box, you know? You got to be a good sport about it.
When's Mom supposed to bait on the radio?
7:30.
Hey, Dad, you know what I was thinking about?
No, what?
Well, what if Mom gets elected prosecuting attorney and, say, after I get my driver's license, I get arrested for something? Would Mom prosecute her own son?
Yes, she would. Your mother has a very high sense of morality, and she would never show favoritism. As a matter of fact, once she's elected, if any of you do anything wrong, you'll all go to prison.
Mr. Evans?
Yes?
Fontana Beausoleil, the striptease artist?
Oh, sure. I'm familiar with her work. Not personally, but I've heard about it.
Well, I want to thank you for that wonderful editorial you wrote, criticizing government interference in the arts.
Thank you. I try.
You succeed.
Your change, Mr. Evans.
Oh, thank you. Well, what are you all doing here? Your toaster blow up?
Reading out because Mom had to go to bait Jim Guy Puckett on the radio.
Is that this morning? I thought it was tomorrow.
You enjoy the kitty breakfast?
Yes, I do. Just the right portion.
Grandpa, what prize did you get in yours?
I got a ring that glows.
Can I have it?
Nope. I'm keeping it for myself.
Who is doing all that honking?
That is my sister, also known as your mother's Aunt Frieda. We're on our way to a board meeting at the newspaper. She insisted on going through the drive-through window. I come in here because I don't like to eat in the car. She's staying out there because she doesn't like to eat in here.
Hey, here it is.
We're talking this morning with Evening Shade prosecuting attorney.
is morning in Evening Shade, and this is the old hardware store of Mr. Arb Newton, a man who refused to use gimmicks or to sell plastic stuff that tears up the next day. Instead, he sold wheelbarrows and hammers and garden gloves, things that people really need. In a world of whiny, neurotic, self-indulgent people, Mr. Arb shone like a booster rocket. Lots of folks around here still miss him, but this week, the 30th anniversary of his death, he will be mostly and quietly remembered by one person, and that person is his son.
Dad, would you listen to this? Dad.
Hmm? Oh, I'm sorry, honey, what is it?
He's supposed to make up a fable that has a moral to it.
A fable? Isn't he a little young for a fable?
He's gifted.
Yeah, I keep forgetting.
There's a boy named Will. His mother bought him some pants-up pennies. He went to recess, he tore the pants up, and he got in trouble.
What's the lesson?
Don't buy pants-up pennies.
Sounds good to me. Want to go help your brother bring that stuff over here?
Dad?
Uh-huh?
Would you buy me a bra?
Oh, honey, you're just a little girl. I don't want you to wear a bra yet. You know that little undershirt you wear? I'd like you to wear that the rest of your life.
Daddy.
Sorry, Dad, they're out of sweetener. You want me to go next door to Stop and Go?
No, I'll just have it back.
All right, well, this is mine.
I had the Kiss Sunrise sandwich. I knew it. It's a dinosaur. I've already got a dinosaur.
I got a ring that glows.
That's what I wanted. How come I couldn't have that box?
Because that's the way life is. Sometimes you get the wrong box, you know? You gotta be a good sport about it.
When's Mom supposed to bait on the radio?
7:30.
Hey, Dad, you know what I was thinking about?
No, what?
Well, what if Mom gets elected prosecuting attorney and, say, after I get my driver's license, I get arrested for something? Would Mom prosecute her own son?
Yes, she would. Your mother has a very high sense of morality, and she would never show favoritism. As a matter of fact, once she's elected, if any of you do anything wrong, you'll all go to prison.
Mr. Evans?
Yes?
Fontana Beausoleil, the striptease artist?
Oh, sure. I'm familiar with her work. Not personally, but I've heard about it.
Well, I want to thank you for that wonderful editorial you wrote criticizing government interference in the arts.
Thank you. I try.
You succeed.
Your change, Mr. Evans.
Oh, thank you. So what are you all doing here? Your toaster blow up?
Reading out because Mom had to go to bait Jim Guy Puckett on the radio.
Is that this morning? I thought it was tomorrow.
You enjoy the kitty breakfast?
Yes, I do. Just the right portion.
Grandpa, what prize did you get in yours?
I got a ring that glows.
Can I have it?
Nope. I'm keeping it for myself.
Who is doing all that honking?
That is my sister, also known as your mother's Aunt Frieda. We're on our way to a board meeting at the newspaper. She insisted on going through the drive-through window. I come in here because I don't like to eat in the car. She's staying out there because she doesn't like to eat in here.
Hey, here it is.
We're talking this morning with Evening Shade prosecuting attorney Jim Guy Puckett and his opponent in the upcoming general election, Mrs. Ava Newton.
If I can, Randy, I'd like to get back to the downtown parking meter situation.
Well, I think a far more pressing problem is our lack of a domestic violence unit.
Good shot.
May I take your order, please?
Wood Newton,